Hello there. We are the Redemptorists, more formally known as the Congregation of the Most Holy Redeemer. We are a religious congregation within the Holy Catholic Church. We are a worldwide family together with brothers, fathers, associated religious sisters, and lay partners. We form one missionary body, united by a common charism, to evangelize the most abandoned, especially the poor, and to be evangelized by them. For nearly 300 years, we have felt called to follow the example of Jesus Christ the Redeemer in proclaiming the good news to the poor, as he said of himself.
The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he hath anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor.
We follow Jesus in the way of St. Alphonsus Maria de Liguori, our founder. At the core of our proclamation is the good news of plentiful redemption. Through words and concrete actions, we proclaim the love of God, who first loved us and sent his Son. We believe that, as Scripture says, with the Lord is mercy, and with him is plentiful redemption. For us, this means that God, through Christ, offers salvation to every person who is open to receive it. We believe that this plentiful redemption affects the entire human person, brings to perfection and transforms all human values, unites all things in Christ, eventually leading them to completion in a new earth and a new heaven, as we hear in the book of Revelation. The badge of fidelity and the very reason why the congregation exists in the church is so that Redemptorists may have a preference for situations where there is pastoral need, that is, for evangelization in the strict sense, together with a choice in favor of the poor. To understand how we came to be, we need to go back in time to 18th century Enlightenment Europe. Alphonsus lived at a time when in his hometown of Naples, Italy, and even more so the surrounding rural areas, simple people were deprived of moral and religious instruction. Abandoned for social and political reasons, they were outcasts. Although there were many priests in the city, they lacked pastoral zeal and sensitivity to the needs of the people. In the rural countryside, many people had never seen a priest for decades and remained poorly catechized despite living in a Catholic country. The laity was torn between two extremes. On the one hand, because of overzealous preachers of judgment and hellfire, they were driven to excessive fear of God, leading them often to irrational scrupulosity. On the other hand, thinking that God and meaning were totally absent from their lives, many people, especially the poor, began to lose themselves in various forms of moral vice and crime. In this context, the young Alphonsus was being prepared for a brilliant career as a lawyer by his navy officer dad, and for sanctity by his pious convent-bred mom. He completed doctorates in civil and canon law at the tender age of 16. However, Alphonsus always felt that something deeper was calling out to him, coming from his religious upbringing. Nevertheless, Alphonsus soon began with legal practice. He proved himself to be honest and competent in his profession. But constantly, he refused marriage proposals, as, unknown to his father, Alphonsus had made a private vow of chastity. Then came a fateful day when, tricked by corruption in the courts, Alphonsus lost his first case. World, I know you now. Farewell to the courts. With these words of disillusionment, Alphonsus stormed out of the courts. and went to visit the incurable patients in a nearby hospital. While there ministering to the needs of the sick, he heard the words of God leading him into a spiritual realization. He heard the Lord saying to him, "Leave the world and give yourself to me." This was enough for Alphonsus to decide to become a priest. No amount of appeals, protests, or threats from his father could convince the young man to change his mind. He completed his seminary training and, at the age of 30, was ordained a priest for the Diocese of Naples. He soon began working zealously as a preacher of parish missions in Naples, distinguishing himself as a down-to-earth preacher of the truths of the gospel, which could be understood by even the common people. Alphonsus's zeal knew no bounds, but his tireless work eventually took a toll on his health. On the advice of his friends, Father Alphonsus took a break in the countryside town of Scala to recuperate. Here, while on retreat, he had a providential encounter with poor goatherds. What struck Alphonsus about these goatherds was how ignorant they were about the basic truths of the faith and about how much God loved them. This and many other subsequent experiences eventually convinced Alphonsus that God was calling him to establish a religious congregation which would dedicate itself to evangelize abandoned people on the peripheries of the church and society. Very soon, recognizing the good work being done by Father Alphonsus and his companions, many others were drawn to join the fledgling missionary family. In this way, God granted a unique charism to the church through Saint Alphonsus. Many other Redemptorists contributed to the development of this charism over the decades. We have the saintly religious brother, Saint Gerard Majella, popularly known as the Mother Saint and the Family Saint. The second founder, Saint Clement Hofbauer, who ensured the new congregation spread quickly across Europe against all odds. Saint John Neumann, the founder of Catholic education in the USA, and many other blessed martyrs and other lesser-known holy confreres who joined the congregation over time and up to the present day. In India, the Redemptorist congregation was established by Irish missionaries of the Dublin province in the 1940s. They established the apostolate of preaching popular missions and retreats for spiritual renewal in English and later on in the local languages. Indian vocations soon joined and the mission grew. Finally, on the 15th of August 1972, a separate Indian province named after the city of Bangalore was established. Ever since then, the Redemptorists have been serving in the Archdiocese of Bangalore for the last 50 years. However, Redemptorists in India today work beyond Bangalore city, from Ambala in the north to Kanyakumari in the south, from Goa in the west to Bengal in the east, and including the Chota Nagpur area of central India. We comprise three administrative units: the Ligori province, the Vice province of Majella, and the Mother province of Bangalore. In 1991, on the occasion of the Silver Jubilee of the province, the Kenya mission was inaugurated by Indian missionaries. Today, local vocations are joining us and the mission is growing steadily. And this year, 2022-23, the Bangalore province of Redemptorists celebrates its golden jubilee. Redemptorists today seek creative fidelity to this founding charism which God gave the church through Saint Alphonsus. We do this through a variety of ministries. All over the world, we work in parish and shrine ministry, popular missions and retreats to various groups, teaching moral theology, social work, and education for marginalized groups, youth ministry, and media ministry. What defines a Redemptorist is not so much the type of work that we do, but the zeal and creativity with which we do it. We call this trait our missionary dynamism. Whatever a Redemptorist does, he is called to do it with and in the community. Across the globe, we are also known for our availability and closeness to people, and our zeal to proclaim the Word of God, especially to those who do not yet experience the gospel as good news. We are also defined by our care for the most abandoned, especially the poor, which inspires us to keep discerning new and creative ways to reach out to the peripheries, as Pope Francis has exhorted the Church in recent times, and as Jesus Christ our Redeemer has shown us by his own example from the very beginning. Saint Alphonsus is today known as a zealous preacher of the Word of God, an author of several books and tracts, an artist and musician for the gospel, a friend of the poor, a bishop for the most abandoned, a model and patron for confessors and moral theologians, and a learned doctor of the Church, one of the only 37 so proclaimed in the entire history of the Church. Just like Saint Alphonsus and our other Redemptorist saints, blessed and martyrs of the past, every Redemptorist is a person who has been deeply touched by the love of God in Christ the Redeemer. We recognize God's love in the four loves of Saint Alphonsus: the crib, the cross, the Eucharist, and Mother Mary, whom we venerate in a special way as the Mother of Perpetual Help and the Immaculate Conception. It is this which motivates us to share the good news of God's love with all. The same love also moves us out of our comfort zones to seek out the poor and the most abandoned. And like Alphonsus, more than just bringing the people to the Church, we strive to take the Church to the people. Today, the Redemptorist congregation is nearly 5,000 members strong, and its mission is spread across 82 countries all over the world. Do you wish to be a Redemptorist? Then get ready to become someone who is strong in faith, rejoicing in hope, burning with charity, on fire with zeal, in humility of heart, and persevering in prayer. As Redemptorists, we share in the mystery of Christ and proclaim it in gospel simplicity of life and language, so that we may bring to people the good news of plentiful redemption.